In Zoom, if you meet people regularly, you might like to share with them your personal meeting ID. This just makes it easier for them to know how to join your meeting without you sending out a new invitation each time. Now, I'm going to show you where you can find your personal meeting ID in Zoom. And this is available even on the free basic account for Zoom. Now, sharing your personal meeting ID or PMI, it's not the sort of thing that you would share on social media or share it publicly on a website, because you are really making yourself available to people who you know and who meet you regularly. So here is where we say we want the option for a personal meeting ID. Toggle that on or off. But I want to leave that one on. And you can also use your personal meeting ID when scheduling a meeting or even when starting an instant meeting. Just toggle those on or off if you want. You also don't want to use your PMI for back-to-back meetings, because somebody may be in the meeting that ends at 11 a.m. and somebody might join your meeting room just a couple of minutes before 11 a.m. And so that works only if you use the waiting room or some other security measure, just so that they don't go and join your meeting a bit too early. Now, when you log into Zoom and go into settings, if you go to meetings here, you can schedule a meeting. And this is where you can say, hey, I want this to use my PMI, my personal meeting ID, or you can generate a new meeting ID automatically each time there's a new meeting. Now, if you go into settings in Zoom on the desktop, you get to see your personal meeting ID settings. There's a PMI passcode, which you can show if you want. Now, you can set up a personal meeting ID for regular meetings. You could use it if you're a teacher and you wanted to set up office hours, then that would be a great option for you to set up that personal meeting ID and share that link. Between this time and this time, I'm available in this Zoom meeting. Now, if you want to learn more about Zoom personal meeting IDs, check the Zoom official video, which is linked below, or the documentation also provided on zoom.us on their website.